Hello everyone, welcome to your very own channel sonisinghphysics. Friends, in this video we are going to talk about ozone. What is ozone? How ozone is formed naturally? How it is getting destroyed with ODS? ODS means ozone depleting substances. And what are the protective measures we are taking to prevent it from the further destructions? So all these things we are going to see in this video. So let's watch it. In 2010, a report from the United Nations claimed that levels of atmospheric ozone between 1996 and 2009 were 4% lower than before 1980. Ozone is a greenhouse gas that can be found in both the troposphere, that is bad ozone, and stratosphere, good ozone, but it is concentrated at a height of about 25 km in the stratosphere. The ozone layer exists because oxygen filtering from the top of the troposphere reacts with the influence of ultraviolet radiations to form ozone. Now we will see this reaction on the board, that how ozone formed naturally. Now we are going to see all the reactions of ozone. This is our Earth. These are atmospheric layers above Earth, troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, exosphere. We say thermosphere also. Our concern is stratosphere. Ozone presents in this stratosphere. Now we'll see how this ozone formed, how this ozone has come here. This is our sun. Sun rays are reaching towards Earth. This radiation has UV radiation also. Now what happened? From troposphere, oxygen reaches to stratosphere, O2, reaches to stratosphere. This O2 dissociates into nascent oxygen with the help of UV rays of sun, UV rays, and this is called photochemical reaction. Photochemical reaction. So in this way, oxygen breaks into two, O and O, two nascent oxygen. Now what will happen? Again, O2 will react with one nascent oxygen and form O3. So in this way, formation of ozone takes place naturally. This natural balance has been disrupted by human activities, causing the concentration of ozone to fall. The main danger is chlorine, which reacts with oxygen in a destructive process. Now we'll see on board how chlorine destroy ozone. Now we'll see how this ozone get destroyed with this CFC. CFCs, full form of CFC is chlorofluorocarbon. So as per the name, chlorine present in it, and this chlorine is dangerous for ozone. The sources of the CFCs are plastic manufacturing industries, cooling system, refrigeration fluid, and aerosol sprays. So from all these sources, CFCs reaches to a stratosphere, and there with the help of UV rays, it reacts with ozone and destroy it. So now we'll see it through reaction. So chlorine of CFC combines with ozone with the help of sunlight and form ClO plus O2. Then further what happened? This ClO combines with nascent oxygen and form Cl plus 2O2. Further what happened? ClO also combined with O3 and form 2O2 plus Cl. So as you can see, again this Cl is out in the stratosphere to react with next ozone. So in this way, 2O3 will convert it into 2O2. So the two molecules of ozone get destroyed with this Cl. As ozone depletes in the stratosphere, it forms a hole. In 1985, a seasonal depletion in the layer of ozone was found above Antarctica. This hole allowed harmful ultraviolet radiation to enter the Earth's atmosphere. In the southern hemisphere winter, air over Antarctica is cut off from the rest of the atmosphere by the polar vortex, strong winds sweeping around the continent. High in the stratosphere, clouds form from tiny ice particles in the intense cold, and on their surfaces, chemical reactions involving CFCs take place, releasing chlorine, which reacts with the oxygen in the ozone layer. Destruction of the ozone layer begins when the spring sun arrives. The Montreal Protocol is the global agreement to protect the stratospheric ozone layer by phasing out the production of ODS. ODS means ozone depleting substances like CFCs. Now we'll see what is the alternative of this CFC. So HCFC, HCFC and HFC, these two compounds are considered as alternative of this CFC. Full form of HCFC is hydrochlorofluorocarbon and full form of HFC is hydrofluorocarbon. So these two compounds are considered as alternative for CFCs. Now we'll see what we can do from our side to protect our ozone layer. So protective measures. First, we can do avoid the consumption of gases like CFCs, hydrogenated carbon, methyl bromide, and nitrous oxide. These are called ODS. Second, we can do minimize the use of car. So we can use bicycle. Third, we can do try to replace cleaning products by vinegar and bicarbonate. Then fourth, we can do maintain air conditioning.